Hello, welcome to my channel. In this lesson, we study E in Greek. E in Greek might be Eta, Iota, Ypsilon, Omicron Iota, Epsilon Iota. All these sounds in Greek are pronounced usually as E. So, today we're going to understand how to use E, these different sounds. Actually, the same sound, but these different types of pronouncing E in Greek. The most practical thing is to give you some examples in order to familiarize yourselves with particular instances. In this way, you will understand the rules better, I think. Η γάτα, ενικός αριθμός. Η γάτα είναι εδώ. So you see that ita usually accompanies feminine nouns. And then you can see that we have singular form. And afterwards an example using the noun η γάτα. Η γάτα είναι εδώ. This is a positive form. Now, if I intonate in a different way, in a question manner, it's going to be a question in Greek. Η γάτα είναι εδώ. Η γάτα είναι εδώ. Also, I can say είναι η γάτα εδώ. Είναι η γάτα εδώ. In English, a question work only if I start with a verb. In Greek, just by intonating, by affirmative, transforming it into a question form, it works the same. Οι γάτες, πληθυντικός αριθμός. Οι γάτες. As you can see, in the plural form, the sound E remains the same, but it is written in a different manner. And then another example using οι γάτες. Οι γάτες είναι εκεί. Οι γάτες είναι εκεί. The cats are there. Εκεί, there. Το αστέρι. So asteri is a neuter word, and usually when we have a neuter word in Greek, the last letter when it is pronounced as E is iota. This is a rule which occurs 99%. So have it in mind. Το αστέρι, ενικός αριθμός. Then an example. Example in Greek is παράδειγμα. Ένα παράδειγμα. Το αστέρι είναι όμορφο. Positive form. The star is beautiful. Είναι το αστέρι όμορφο. Or το αστέρι είναι όμορφο. Now I will show you how to make a negative sentence in Greek. Το αστέρι δεν είναι όμορφο. You just use the word δεν, which means not. Τα αστέρια. In plural form, τα αστέρια. It is pronounced like αστέρια, like having a γάμα, a hidden consonant, γ. But there is no any consonant, it's just that we pronounce it so fast that gives the impression of a consonant as well. Τα αστέρια, because we cannot say τα αστέρια, no, it's not correct, or τα αστέρια. We have to pronounce in a very fast manner. Τα αστέρια, πληθυντικός αριθμός. Τα αστέρια είναι όμορφα. Once again, you can notice that in the neuter form, we always have E, which is written with iota. Τα αστέρια είναι όμορφα. Now I'm going to give you some instances of the negative and question form. Είναι τα αστέρια όμορφα. Τα αστέρια είναι όμορφα. And then negative form, τα αστέρια δεν είναι όμορφα. As you can see, I have underlined είναι. Okay, είναι is a very important verb in Greek. It is a verb be, and είναι might be is or are, because in Greek, είναι can be the same both in plural and singular form. Now, as you can see, it is pronounced είναι, but it is written with an epsilon iota sound. Okay, another thing that I want you here to notice is that είναι, the sound e is not written with an epsilon as you could expect, but with an alpha iota. And that happens because in Greek we can have e, the vowel, the sound e, in two different manners as well. But this is another thing to do, another lesson to study. So, let's move on. Το σχολείο, which means the school. Ενικός αριθμός. Το σχολείο είναι μεγάλο. Now, here you have a neuter word, but because the last letter is not a e, the last sound is not an e, that means that we do not have any rules that we have to apply about iota. So, it is written in a different way. Το σχολείο, with an epsilon iota. Το σχολείο είναι μεγάλο, big. Είναι το σχολείο μεγάλο? Or, το σχολείο είναι μεγάλο? And then, negative form, το σχολείο δεν είναι μεγάλο. Plural form, πληθυντικός αριθμός. Τα σχολεία. So, you can revise the articles as well, the definite articles. Τα σχολεία δεν είναι μεγάλα. The schools are not big. Here you have a negative sentence, then, which means not. And in Greek, always applies, is always applied before a verb. Δεν είναι. But in English we say is not. Okay, it's different, it's the opposite. Ο σκύλος. As you can see the word σκύλος, it is written with an ypsilon. There is no a particular reason why. What I want you to understand through this lesson today is that there are not practical rules in order to remember when and how we use each different instance of V. Every word, every single word is a unique phenomenon, and you should try and study each word itself, and through learning a new word, you learn the different sounds that are pronounced and the letters that make this particular set of lexical items or of a word. Ο σκύλος, ενικός αριθμός. Ο σκύλος παίζει. In Greek, ο σκύλος παίζει can mean two things. Can mean the dog plays or the dog is playing. Because in Greek, we do not have a particular difference between present, continuous and simple. We have a single present, which can be both for now and every day. There are other lexical items into a sentence that make us understand if it is a habitual action or if it is happening right now. Οι σκύλοι, πληθυντικός αριθμός. Οι σκύλοι δεν παίζουν. As you can see, when I have a plural form, in the masculine words, I always apply omicron iota as the sound e. Η σκύλη, πληθυντικός αριθμός, οι σκύλοι δεν παίζουν. Okay, το τραπέζι, the table, ενικός αριθμός. Το τραπέζι είναι άσπρο. Okay, as you can see this sign, it is a mark of expressing question. So I have to intonate in a question manner. Το τραπέζι είναι άσπρο, which means the table is actually the table white. Τα τραπέζια, πληθυντικός αριθμός. As you can notice in the neuter form of a noun, we always have e as iota. Iota again in the plural form. And then an instance. Και έπειτα ένα παράδειγμα. Instance. Παράδειγμα. Τα τραπέζια είναι άσπρα. Which means, are the tables white? In English, we do not apply any suffixes of plural form in colors, but in Greek we do. Attention. So we say, for example, άσπρο for one, άσπρα, άσπρα for many things in neuter form. Άσπρο, it is conjugated as an adjective. So we say ο άσπρος, η άσπρη, το άσπρο. Η άσπρη, η άσπρες, τα άσπρα. Every color is conjugated as an adjective in Greek. Okay. Το κρεβάτι. Ενικός αριθμός. Το κρεβάτι μου είναι εδώ. Now we have a possessive adjective. Okay. Το κρεβάτι μου είναι εδώ. My bed is here. In English, we just say my bed, but in Greek we need a definite article as you can see before the noun. So it could be something equivalent to say in English the bed my or the bed's our. This is the way that the Greek person thinks of the possessive adjectives. Το κρεβάτι μου είναι εδώ. Τα κρεβάτια, πληθυντικός αριθμός. Τα κρεβάτια μας είναι εδώ. And attention, it's not τα κρεβάτια, it's τα κρεβάτια. Once again, there is a τια, τραπεζιά. Τραπεζιά, κρεβάτια. You have to pronounce it in a hard and fast way in order to make this sound. Τα κρεβάτια μας είναι εδώ. Are here. Once again, you revise the word είναι, which can be both is in the singular form, ενικός αριθμός, or in the plural form, are. Το κινητό, ενικός αριθμός. Κινητό is what we call mobile phone. Το κινητό, ιώτα, ήτα, όμικρον. Το κινητό σου είναι υπέροχο. Your mobile phone is lovely. In English, we say your mobile, okay? We do not say the mobile your, but in Greek this is what we say. The mobile your, okay? Το κινητό σου είναι υπέροχο. Let's go to the plural form. Τα κινητά. The mobile phones. The mobile phones. Okay, it is written with iota, eta, alpha. Τα κινητά σας είναι υπέροχα. Your mobile phones are lovely. Σας in Greek is the plural form your. Okay, and I'm stressing the importance of this element because your in English can be both singular and plural form, but in Greek, your is distinguished, which means that ενικός αριθμός is σου, πληθυντικός αριθμός is σας, τα κινητά σας. Είναι υπέροχα. You see the word lovely, which is written with an ypsilon. Okay, υπέροχο for the neuter word in the singular form, υπέροχα. It is an adjective, which is ο υπέροχος, η υπέροχη, το υπέροχο. And in the plural form, η υπέροχη, οι υπέροχες for feminine, τα υπέροχα for the neuter words. Let's see another instance. Η πολυθρόνα, ενικός αριθμός. Η πολυθρόνα is what we call the armchair. Η ήτα, πολυθρόνα, ύψιλον. Okay, η πολυθρόνα, ενικός αριθμός. Η πολυθρόνα του είναι βολική. His armchair is comfortable. Η πολυθρόνα του είναι βολική. His, okay, his, for a man, it is masculine. Η πολυθρόνα του είναι βολική. Ιώτα ήτα. Why ήτα? Because when we have a feminine noun in Greek, it always ends in e, which is an ita. The neuter words end in iota. The feminine words end in ita. E polythrones, there's a mistake here, I have to correct it. E polythrones, πληθυντικός αριθμός. Οι πολυθρόνες τους είναι βολικές. Their armchairs are comfortable. Once again, the adjectives in Greek are conjugated depending on the form. Here we have a plural form, βολικές, and depending on the gender as well. The last example you'll see is the word poly, which is a lovely ancient Greek word. Η πόλη, ενικός αριθμός. Η πόλη είναι υπέροχη. The city is great. You see the word η πόλη, which is written with an e, ita. Η πόλη είναι, είναι εψιλον ιώτα, υπέροχη, υψιλον ita. Η πόλης. When we have a noun which is feminine in the singular form, η πόλης in the plural form, usually we might have εψιλον ιώτα. Οι πόλεις είναι υπέροχες. Okay, that was for today. Thank you for your time. See you in one of my next videos. And don't forget to comment, like or dislike and subscribe to my channel. Bye!